When it comes to riding on the back of creatures in The Witcher, you might expect a unicorn, or maybe even a dragon, but most do not expect knockers. Yet Geralt did ride one of these creatures. Knockers are strange creatures. They are able to talk with humans and negotiate, yet are not as well developed in that aspect as some other races. One way to describe a knocker? It would be a troll. Not a troll in the sense of a rock troll, or a troll that maintains a bridge near a village, more like a prankster. Knockers are annoying creatures. They look like a very large man, covered in fur, as they stand at about 2.5 meters, or about 1.4 Geralt's tall. Yet how they use it is often looked down upon by dwarves and miners. Knockers are a real plague in the Mahakam Mountains, for they have found ways to entertain themselves and get a steady source of liquor. Among the things they do often is hiding in the dwarven mines and running out at some unsuspecting dwarf, knock him around a bit before going back into the tunnels. To prevent many workplace related injuries caused by knockers, the dwarves have started to take copper with them into the mines. They would bang these pieces of copper against the wall to scare off any nearby knockers. But these beasts are other ways of harassing dwarves and miners, mainly by building traps. They would knock over any ladders and wait in ambushes to relieve the dwarves the liquor and spirits. Not to mention, they will often steal tools from the dwarves and sabotage the catwalks in the mines. And that's not even to mention the false floors. It wouldn't surprise me if some dwarves might have died to all these traps, but most of the time the dwarves seem to get off relatively easy. But still, it's not safe to work around creatures that keep sabotaging the dwarven mining operations. And thus, sometimes they decide to hire a witcher. A contract on a knocker, most of the time, doesn't mean that the witcher should kill the beast. What it instead means is that the dwarves want to not be bothered by these creatures for a while. The hunt for a knocker in Mahakam can be somewhat longer than one might hope, as it consists of several days wandering through dwarven mines, avoiding tripwires and traps placed there by knockers. Erlund of Larvik once tracked down a few knockers in Mahakam. It took him 3 days to get to them, and when he finally came face to face to the knockers to talk to them, they started to throw rocks at him. Some witchers would have just grabbed the swords at that point and charged these beasts. But Erlund, while his patience had run out, decided to calm the knockers using Axie to make them more willing to listen. Miners all across the continent have had to deal with these creatures, resulting in a decent list of names these creatures have been given, including Pukas, Koblinau, Polterduk, Karkonos, Rubazal, and Skarbinik. But whatever they call these beasts, miners have started to bribe them to leave them alone. Most of the time, this is done by leaving some bread and butter, along with cheese and smoked fish in a dark tunnel. But of course, the thing these knockers desire the most is alcohol. If bribed with enough alcohol, you can make a knocker do almost whatever you want, including acting like a better version of a horse, which Avelak suggested to Geralt in the books. The knocker reeked like a horse, but that was where similarity ended. Geralt had once seen in Mahakam a mountain goat riding contest organized by dwarves, which had seemed to be totally reckless sport. But it was only now, as he sat on the back of a knocker, as it hurtled insanely up the cliff, that he learned what true recklessness was. In order to not fall off, he dug his fingers tightly into the rough, shaggy coat and squeezed his thighs against the monster's fleecy sides. The knocker stank of sweat, urine, and vodka. It flew as though possessed, the earth thudding under the impact of his gigantic feet, as though its soles were of bronze. Slowing slightly, it climbed up hillsides and pelted down them so fast the wind howled in Geralt's ears. It rushed across ridges, mountain paths, and ledges so narrow Geralt kept his eyes tightly closed, as to not look down. It cleared waterfalls, cascades, chasms, and clefts, too extreme for even mountain goats. And each successful leap was accompanied by a savage and deafening roar. That is, more savage and deafening than a knocker's usual sound, which was something it almost did constantly. Don't race like that. The rush of air shoved the words back down his throat. Why not? You've been drinking. They raced on. The wind whistled in his ears. The knocker reeked. The clatter of immense feet on rocks fell silent. Instead, rock fields and scree rattled. The ground became less rocky, and something that might have been a dwarf pine flashed by. Then a blur of green and brown, for the knocker was loping insane bounds through the fair forest. A scent of resin mingled with the monster stench. Ua! The furs ceased, and fallen leaves whispered. Now red, now claret, ochre and golden. Slow down! Ooh-ha-ha-ha! Knocker cleared a pile of fallen trees for the huge bound. Geralt almost bit a storm off. Knockers are some weird creatures. And while they are very annoying to miners, they do have their uses, mainly as the fastest land transport there is in the mountains. But what do you think about these beasts? Till next video. Bye.